वेलकम बैक. वेल, अश्विनी गुजराल, सुदर्शन सुखानी, नितेश ठक्कर नाउ जॉइनिंग अस. लेट्स सी इफ देयर्स एनी इम्पैक्ट ऑन द एसजीएक्स निफ्टी बिकॉज ऑफ दिस अनाउंसमेंट. नाउ द मार्केट न्यू दैट समथिंग इज अराउंड द कॉर्नर. परहैप्स द मार्केट विल वेट फॉर द एक्चुअल इवेंट, बट स्टिल डाउन अबाउट 40 पॉइंट्स. गुड मॉर्निंग अश्विनी. ऑन द निफ्टी एंड द बैंक निफ्टी, वॉट वुड बी योर ट्रेड नाउ?
Well, good morning, and I don't think, you know, stimulus has really impacted the markets thus far. For the moment, yesterday was a pause day, choppiness, then closing at the highs of the day. I would think that the market, maybe first half remains a bit subdued, but second half onwards, we should see a brisk rally. Markets are overextended, that everybody knows. But they can become more overextended. That is the news. I think, you know, some sort of round numbers, markets get attracted to them, like 12,000, etc. So maybe 13,000 is the figure before you see consolidation. Maybe 30,000 on Bank Nifty are those figures. So basically, if you do open around these levels, I think you should have cause to buy. And once we start taking out yesterday's high, there could be more follow through.
Okay, that's an interesting point, that perhaps second half could be good today and you want to buy the calls on dip. Sudarshan, good morning. Would you have a similar strategy or is there a different view?
Good morning, Anuj. Well, it's almost the same. See, the trend is up. We are making lifetime new highs. So there is only one trade, and that trade is to go and buy the market. Now, luckily for traders, the market is opening almost flat today. So at least that problem of a gap up is not existing for today. Go and buy the Nifty. The easiest way to buy the Nifty, because today is weekly options expiry, the easiest way is to buy at the money call options, which are expiring today. So you have become virtually like futures. With a very small premium, you can participate in a large gain if it comes, or it doesn't come, then you, of course, let it go. So that's the trade. Go long in the morning and keep quiet till the afternoon.
Okay, I like that part. Keep quiet till the afternoon. Mitesh Thakkar is also with us. Mitesh, hi, good morning. What is your view? Would you also suggest going long in this market, and what are the targets you're looking at?
Good morning. We have been trading on the long side, primarily through selling put options on the index and buying stocks, and more aggressive on the stock side. But I've been looking at targets of around 12,750. A couple of days back, we discussed that. And then now at about 12,990, 13,000. As Ashwini also rightly said, the round numbers are important and psychologically crucial levels where some kind of profit booking can occur. So I think this rally might continue till those levels. But yes, any welcome dip, you know, of 50 to 60 points as the SGX is indicating would be a good opportunity to create fresh longs with another 100 point kind of a stop loss on the downside. So the idea would be to buy close to about 12,680, 650 zones, take a 100 point stop loss and look at 12,950, 13,000 as your target area.
Okay. Well, with that, Sudarshan, I just had a doubt. You said go long in the morning when you get the dips and then retain those longs. Is that what you meant by keep quiet in the afternoon, just count your gains?
No, I said just go long in the morning. The dip was not there. You just go long when the market opens in the next 5 or 10 minutes. Buy an at the money call and then do nothing. If the market can be volatile, it can go up and down. So do nothing. Stay with the call till the end of the day.
Got that. Now your stocks, Sudarshan?
Well, the stocks are always much more difficult in such days because we are already buying the Nifty. So large caps are not in my list. BPCL has started going up after a very long protracted bear market. Something interesting is going on there. So we want to go long in BPCL. There are two stocks, both from the infrastructure space, Siemens and L&T. Both have been flying. Siemens is just breaking out, so it's probably a better option if you're looking for a longer term trade. And L&T, we can notch gains even despite the big up run up. So these are two buying ideas apart from BPCL. Century Textile is an intraday short sell.
Okay. It's just that in BPCL, today the crude prices have jumped a lot. Normally it's negative, but one never knows.
Yeah, but you know, BPCL is running up because the deadline is approaching. And now,
yeah,
you know,
the EOI deadline.
Yes, and it's been said that there will not be any more
extension.
Increments, extension of that deadline. So that's the reason that you're seeing that stock rally. But Mitesh, good morning. What are you buying and selling?
Anush, couple of gas names on the list. Gas Authority, it was by call here a couple of days back as well. I think the trend is showing more strength. I would be a buyer here with a stop at about 89.5. Try to buy around 92 on a 50-70% kind of a dip and look at targets of 98. Similarly, IGL, that's a buy with a stop at 438. Again, buy on dips close to about 445, and 460-465 should be the target area. The third buy call is an Aurobindo Pharma. Recommended stop loss is 797, and approximate price targets would be around 840 to about 845. And solitary sell call, that's on Reliance. Keep a stop at 2025. Look for dip to about 1940 levels.
Hey, well, interestingly, today all three experts have at least one stock in the cash market. Ashwani, you have in fact two in the cash market, and overall, all five buy calls.
See, I like to play, you know, macro news, and PLI, according to me, was some sort of macro news. Maybe more is coming. So that way, I think Laurus Labs and these guys have corrected. So that's a buy with a stop of 275, target of 292. Amber Enterprise, not only because of PLI, but I happened to buy some consumer goods, and you know, Croma told me all brands are manufactured by Amber and Dixon, so it doesn't matter which brand you buy. So that way, Amber Enterprise, a buy with a stop of 2200, target of 2350. Apollo Hospital again corrected quite a bit. All of these, you know, stay at home, pharma, healthcare type of things, they are looking positive. So this is a buy with a stop of 2170, target of 2300. And Hindalco is a buy with a stop of 199, target of 214. And Jubilant, after one day's decline, has started moving up. This is a buy with a stop of 2300, target of 2420.
Okay, got that. Gentlemen, we're coming back to you in a minute. We have to take a break. We'll have pre-opening rates. We'll also have Vinod.